Okay, students, in this video here, I'd like to talk a little bit about the solar system and beyond, and sort of talk about what's out there. Like, if you just look up sort of like what might you see out there? So, several things. The first thing that you might see that exists in the solar system are planets, of course. And these, I have some definitions which I'll tell you about. And so a planet, for example, is identified, believe it or not, as something that's being round and has a cleared path. And by the cleared path, of course, we mean that as it moves through the solar system in its path, probably in something called its orbit, it's not going to collide with anything. The path has been clear. Okay. The second thing you might see out there, that exists out there also, is a star. And what a star is, of course, generates its own light. So a star is self-luminous. And you can just think of a star as a ball of gas. Self-luminous ball of gas. And of course, it's the gas that's actually burning. Third thing you might encounter out there is a galaxy. And what a galaxy loosely is here is billions of stars. So you see the star and the galaxy sort of definitely are something you might think of sort of together here. So a star is an individual self-luminous ball of gas, and a galaxy here is then maybe you can think of as billions of stars or collection of billions of stars. It'd be fine. So the galaxy is what happens when a bunch of stars sort of come together and form a group. Next thing you might see out there is a moon, and what a moon sort of is defined as is something that orbits a planet. So we'd be a little bit careful with when we say the word moon, because of course when we say like the word the moon, this sort of implies our moon that orbits the Earth. But other planets have moons, like for example Jupiter, for example, there, the big planet that we discussed a little bit a few slides ago here, has something like 67 plus moons, a whole bunch of them. Mars, for instance, this planet that we're interested in visiting someday, has two moons. So the Earth isn't the only planet with a moon, although the word the moon is sort of reserved for our moon. The fifth thing that's out there are things called asteroids. And these are definitely things that are smaller than a planet, but also orbit a star. And so what we mean by that, of course, is when we draw our model of the solar system, we sort of had the sun here in the center, and this is sort of our sun here, and the sun is a star. And the way we drew just the Earth, for example, here is we drew the Earth sort of going around the sun like this, going around the star. So there's the Earth in its tilt sort of going around, and that's the orbit. And so what an asteroid is, of course, it is smaller than the planet, as we're saying here. It's smaller than a planet, but it also orbits the star. And so typically, the orbit of an asteroid won't look so localized like this. The orbit of an asteroid might look something more like this. It just comes from way far away and might come in and do something like this, then go way far back again. Like, I can't even draw where it might turn around out here, but the asteroid might be this thing that comes in like this. So technically it does orbit the star like this, but typically it comes around, as we said here, comes around like this from way, way, way far away, goes around the star, leaves again, then it sort of spends a long time way, way, way out there. If I could just sort of draw it going way, 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 way out here, and then maybe turning around again and coming in. So you can see that, like the Earth, it definitely orbits the star over and over, but on a very long elliptical orbit like that is typical of what you might get from an asteroid there. And yes, this is the issue of asteroids do from time to time come close to the Earth in those orbits, but that's what we mean by they orbit a star, but smaller than a planet. Number six are comets. And what comets are basically a bunch of ice and dust. You can definitely think of them as a dirty snowball. And they typically have orbits that look a lot like those of the asteroids as well. And we'll talk about comets and where they come from, and we have a few things to say about them. And then the other sort of last thing I'll talk about here is a meteor. A meteor can be anything like rock, ice, dust. And these things typically try to enter our atmosphere. In other words, these meteors here do fall to Earth. But because they're moving so fast and they encounter the air in the Earth's atmosphere, so something like this, if here's sort of the surface of the Earth and we have all this nice air up here that we breathe, when the meteor tries to come in like this, it has to penetrate through the air, and when it does so, it gets very, very hot and it starts to get very, like, red hot, and most of the time would just burn up before it comes in. And so these meteors sometimes are called shooting stars, although they are not stars by any means. So anyway, that's the conclusion of this video here. There's generally, like I said, about seven things here that we intend to encounter out there as we study astronomy and go through our solar system and even the galaxy if needed here. But there's definitely planets, there's stars, there's galaxies, which are a collection of stars. There's the moon, which is our moon, but of course there are moons because other planets have moons. There are asteroids, there are comets, which are the dirty ice balls, and there's meteors, which form this idea of a shooting star that are really just rock, ice, and dust trying to enter the Earth's atmosphere but end up burning up when they encounter the air in our atmosphere.